It was here at the weather station 11,000 feet up the side of a Hawaiian volcano called Mauna Loa that they first found out what was actually going on. At the time, people had been looking at ice cores drilled out of the Greenland ice cap, ice cores that contained trapped air bubbles, frozen in the snow that stacked up year after year in ice layers, an annual atmosphere record. And they had 160,000 years of those ice layers. They analyzed all the air in those bubbles, and they got this. Over thousands of years, here's the carbon dioxide level in black going up and down, see it? But look, here in blue is a temperature rise, shadowing it almost exactly. And look at this. These two levels linked in the same way over the same period of time to the methane level. See? Up here in mid-Pacific, well away from industrial pollution, from 1958 on, they started measuring the amount of carbon dioxide in the modern atmosphere, and they got this. Down in spring, up in autumn. Spring, autumn, spring, autumn. Remember the plants? But look at the overall trend. Up. Man-made excess, that. Too much for the oceans to absorb. And at the same time, look at methane levels and another greenhouse gas, CFCs. And look at this. Global temperature rise over the previous 100 years. Well, you didn't need a PhD, especially when you had a look at two other key trends. Fossil fuel emission and deforestation. None of those things was going that way. The scientists dropped their graphs and reached for their diaries to set up some conferences. 1970, climate change. 72, environment. 74, the ozone layer. 76, greenhouse gases. Then the politicians got involved. 1980, the UN. 81, the White House. 83, the National Academy. 85, UN again. 86, ozone again. 87, environment. 88, a call for action. 89, a call for action. 90, another call for action. 91, another call for action. 92, guess what?